Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Whatever your knowledge is of the neck right now, I'll guarantee you that after going through this lesson, you will have a much better understanding for chords and notes on the neck. What we're going to do is take three notes in two different directions across the guitar. The format of this approach will help you to see and use the notes in a variety of shapes. Then all the notes will be associated back to triad chords and arpeggios, so you understand how to visualize as well as use these in both scales and in harmony. After this, join me for the second half of the lesson on Patreon, where I'll take everything that we're going to cover here in the YouTube lesson and apply it through a new tonality. Plus, I'll introduce new ways of visualizing the application of every example by playing and using these triads in a new direction. So let's play through our first group of triads. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. The most popular three-note structure that we have in music is called the triad. It can be played either as a chord or as an arpeggio. But one of the often overlooked things about the triad is that it makes up a majority of the notes also found inside of the pentatonic scale. So the first exercise that we're going to do has a major triad being used as the basis to play some pentatonic phrases. So the first thing that we're going to look at here is the low region layout, and it's just going to be set up. You can see the tab coming up on the screen right now. It's going to be set up like this. All right, so we have our cascading triads that are going across the guitar strings from the high strings down to the low strings. And now that we have that set up on the neck and we have our region together, the next thing that we're going to do is take a look at a pentatonic guitar lick set up in that same region. Check it out. All right, one more time. You can see it coming up on the screen here. So that's a D major pentatonic lick, and it's based around the D triad shapes that are forming a stacked group of triads over in this area of the neck. Now what we're going to do next is move upwards into the fifth position. So now we'll be in the mid-range region of the neck, and we'll set up some new triad stacks here in this mid-region. Same key, D major. So now we're set up in that middle region. Let's, now that we've got the triad stacks together in this region, let's also set up a D major pentatonic guitar lick. You can tell we're following the region of the triad stacks now. So in a D major triad, we have three notes, D, F sharp, and A. And then when we take a look at what's going on with the D major pentatonic scale, we've got D, E. So we have an E note that's a little bit different. We have the F sharp, we have the A note, and we have one extra note here, it's a B. So the B and the E are the extra notes, and the D, F sharp, and A are already there as part of the triad. So as you go across the guitar neck, you really get to know the locations of the D, F sharp, and A in this case, because we're doing D major. But as we build the D major pentatonic lick around the same region, we're also getting used to finding out where those E notes and the B notes can get popped in and just enhance the sound a little bit. Now, we've covered two regions of the neck. Let's get one more going on here. This time we're going to be up in the upper high region of the neck. You can see this next group of triad stacks coming up on the screen right now. Check it out. It sounds like this. All right, so now we've got the triad stacks set up there in the high region. Let's just add in a guitar lick based out of the D major pentatonic. Thank you. So one more time. We're just leaning into this A note here, right at the 12th fret of the 5th string. So as you can tell, it's really easy to put this information together, and you just want to keep a couple things in mind. As you're practicing it, you know, you want to understand where the D, F sharp, and A notes are. If we go right back to the very beginning in this low region set, you know, we have a small D major chord set up here of A, D, F sharp, and then as it goes across, it just stacks F sharp, A, D, and then it goes D, F sharp, A, and then finally A, D, F sharp. So understand that so you get your notes together for the setup of the triad stack. And then the only other thing is to understand when you're doing your guitar licks, what's happening with the specific notes that are taken from the, in this case, D major pentatonic scale. Again, remember the D, F sharp, and A are already a part of the major pentatonic scale. We only have two extra notes that are added. In this case, it's the second of the scale and the sixth of the scale. So what we're going to do right now is take a break from this information, and I hope to catch up with you next on the part two of this lesson, which is found on Patreon. If you just go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio, you'll find that. And in the second section of this, we're going to be covering ideas that are based around minor tonality, and we're going to get you a really good exercise on what we'll call visualization. We're going to learn to see the geometry of each of these regions of the neck, and it's going to really help solidify things way more. The note recognition will go and bump up to the next level for you. And another thing that we're going to look at is how you can go out of these specific positions and build a line that connects from one to the next, so you totally understand exactly how the triad stacks go and connect over to what's happening with the major pentatonic scale. So I look forward to seeing you there next. And, you know, please go and also check out my guitar lessons website at creativeguitarstudio.com. There's absolutely fantastic lessons over there. I have a complete beginners, intermediate, and advanced guitar players program over there. And as well, there's some fantastic electives. I've got guitar soloing, guitar technique, rhythm guitar, ear training. There's a whole bunch of great stuff. Our most popular program right now is the acoustic guitar course, and you're going to love all that stuff. So go check that out on my lessons website, creativeguitarstudio.com. And for the second half of this lesson, head over to Patreon, sign up at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I'll take everything that we've covered here in the YouTube lesson with triad stacks and apply all of it through the tonality of minor. Plus, I'll introduce a new way you can use to visualize the application of the triad, both major and minor, by playing and using the triad stacks right alongside of pentatonic licks. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get a jam track and also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all of the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.